Next, we're going to create an application user by selecting User Management and Application and clicking Add New. This is going to be our Axle user, so create an appropriate user ID, password. This user will be created so that the Cisco Unified Presence server can log into the Cisco Unified Communications Manager and do directory searches. Scroll down, and we're going to select all three student phone devices, which in our case will be Cisco IP Communicators, and click Save. Next, navigate to User Management, User Groups, click Add New, and create a user group for our Axle user by giving it an appropriate name. Select Save and confirm a successful update at the top of the web page. Next, we'll add our users to this group, our Axle user to this group, by selecting Add Application User, clicking Find, and selecting the user we created previously. Next, click Add Selected, and this user will be part of this group. We must now give this group some rights, so we'll go to Related Links, select Assign Roles to User Group, and click Go. From this page, click Assign Role to Group, click Find, and select the standard Axle API access. Scroll to the bottom and select Add Selected. Click Save, and again check for a successful update. We must restart the Axle service, so select from the navigation window Cisco Unified Serviceability, select Go. From the Tools menu, select Control Feature Services. Select the Cisco Axle Web Service and click the green box that is for restart. Select OK to the warning message and wait for the screen to refresh and navigate back to the administrator webpage. Next, we're going to do a device association by going to Device, Phones, and selecting Find. Three soft phones have already been created on the server, so we will select the first one. Click on the line. Scroll to the bottom of the page. And select Associate End User. Select User 1 for Phone 1 and click Add Selected. Click Save and click Go on Related Links to make our way back to the other three phones. Do click Go twice. Do this again for the other two phones, for User 2 and User 3. In this section, we will add Cisco Unified Personal Communicator devices to the Cisco Unified Communications Manager database. To create a CUPC device, select Device, Phone, click Add New, and from the Phone Type menu, scroll to the bottom and select Cisco Unified Personal Communicator. Click Next and enter the name. In this case, we must enter it with a UPC name. So here I will type in UPC User 1. I will give it a description. Select my device pool. In this case, we only have one. I must also select a standard Unified Communications SIP template for my phone button template. I will scroll down one page, and under Owner User ID, I will select User 1. Under the Primary Phone, I will select Student 01, which is the phone for User 1. I will then again scroll down another page, setting my SIP information. I will set my device security profile to Communicator Standard, set my SIP profile to Standard SIP Profile, and select my digest user as User 1. Click Save. This warning message is telling you need to apply the config to create a config file in the TFTP server, so I will hit OK. When the screen refreshes, I will click Apply Config. From the pop-up window, select OK. Next, I will select my line 1 and enter in the extension number for this particular phone. In this case, it'll be 2001. I will hit Tab to update the screen. And I will scroll down to the bottom to enter in my line appearance. So under line 1, I will do my display. If I hit Tab, it'll fill in the ASCII version of this for phones that are using ASCII. I will set my busy trigger to 6 from the default of 2, and I will scroll to the bottom of the page. Select Associate End User, select User 1 as the associated user, and click Add Selected. If I scroll to the bottom, I can see that my User 1 is the associated user, and I will click Save. At the top, sometimes you see that it didn't save. You might have to hit Save twice. Then I will hit Go twice to go back to the list of phone devices and click Add New again. I will do the same thing for my other two phones.